Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Blessed be our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Holy Lamb of God. Y'all, I was just sitting here in my room, man. I was just staring at my heater, you know, and I got to thinking about what hell is like. You know, the human mind can't even wrap around what hell is really like, you know, and you know, it's sad that it's many people in the world that don't even believe that hell even exists. You know, and there are people in the world today that believe in the Holy Bible, but they don't believe that hell exists. You know, and if you really study the scriptures of the book of Matthew, Mark, and Luke, Jesus Christ, he preached more about hell and fire and brimstone than he did about heaven. Because he was warning us. He wanted us to know that hell is a real place. And you know, I was just sitting here in my room, y'all, and while I'm drinking my water, I ain't no water in hell. But I was just sitting here in my room, drinking my water, staring at the heater. And it's like lately, y'all, God just been talking to me through so many things around me. He just been speaking to me while I'm at work, God just speaking to me. Things around me, he just showing me things. And today when I came home and I just been staring at the heater, and God just been ministering to my spirit about hell, and I've been trying to figure out what hell is really like, but my mind can't wrap around it. Only thing I can do is just go back to the scriptures of what Jesus said and just try to imagine it. You know, in the book of Matthew, y'all, Jesus Christ, what's up, Brother Jamie? You know, in the book of Matthew, y'all, Jesus Christ said that hell, it's a place where the fire never quenches and the worm never dies in hell. And you know, when he said that the fire never quenches, what's up, Sister Kia? And you know, when he said that the fire never quenches, this is the fire that you can't put out. This ain't no fire that you see on earth where you can get a fire extinguisher, or you can call the fire department and have them bring some water, hook it up, and throw water on it and put it out. This ain't that type of fire. This ain't one of those fires that you see when you cut on your stove if you got gas. This ain't that type of fire. Jesus said it's the fire that never quenches. It can't be put out. This is a fire that God created for the devil and his demons. But because of sin and humanity, many people go there. And many people are there right now while I'm speaking this message to you, y'all. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 5 verse 14. The Bible says that hell hath enlarged herself and opened her mouth wide without measure. Hell is getting bigger every single day because there are many people that's going to hell than it is to heaven. Because people are in their sins. They haven't truly surrendered their life to Jesus Christ, y'all. It's people that's dying in their sins every single day and lifting their eyes up in hell. And that's why the Bible say hell hath enlarged herself and opened her mouth wide without measure. I know a lot of pastors in the church today, some, not all of them now, some don't really preach about hell and fire and brimstone. They don't really tell you about hell because they know what the people want to hear. And you know, Paul told Timothy, he said, the time will come and the time is here, that people will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust, they will heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth. They shall turn away from sound doctrine and give heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. And that's how people live in the world today. They like, don't tell me about sin. Don't tell me about my sins. Tell me that I'm about to get a car. Tell me that I'm about to get a house. Tell me I'm about to get a financial breakthrough. Don't tell me about my sins, though. Don't tell me nothing about hell. Tell me about the love of God. Tell me that God loved me and I can still get to heaven in my sins. That's how people is today. They got itching ears. That's what they want to hear. They don't want you to tell them about sin. They don't want to hear about sin. They don't want to feel convicted of their sins. Don't nobody want to get this a wicked and perverse generation. Hallelujah. Don't nobody want to feel convicted in their sins. Don't nobody want to be rebuked. Don't nobody want to be corrected because people just think they know everything. But you know nothing if you don't study the scriptures. Jesus said, in the scripture shall you find all truth. People is lifted up in pride today. And when you tell them about their sins, stop judging me. Stop condemning me, they say. The way you preaching is pushing people away from God. Don't tell me about my sins. It's none of your business what I do. Only God can judge me, they say. And you're right. And one day God is going to judge you. One day you're going to stand before a holy and a righteous God that's going to judge you. And he ain't going to have no mercy and judgment. Once you stand before God and give account of your life, if you wasn't living holy and righteous, applying his word to your life, Jesus said in Matthew 7, I will tell them, depart from me. I never knew you, you worker of iniquity. And you're going to be thrown in a place where it's fire and brimstone. Jesus said in hell, people are weeping and gnashing their teeth. They just gritting their teeth because they being tormented in them flames. They feeling torture and pain and they crying out in agony. Jesus said people weeping and gnashing their teeth in hell. And you know something else Jesus Christ said? In the book of Matthew chapter 5. Jesus said if your eyes cause you to sin. He said pluck them out and cast it away from you. For it's better for you to enter into the kingdom of heaven with no eyes. Rather than your whole body be thrown in a lake of fire. You know what else Jesus said, y'all? Jesus said, if your hand, all you people that's masturbating and watching porn, touching on people you ain't got no business touching. Jesus said, if your hand caused you to sin, he said, cut it off and cast it away from you. It's better for you to enter into the kingdom of heaven with no hand than for your whole body to be thrown into the lake of fire. Jesus said, whatever is in your life that's causing you to sin, he's saying, cut it off. Whoever you got in your life that's causing you to fall short of God's glory, that's causing you to disobey his word, and you know his truth, you know what his word says, and you still holding on to people that's causing you to fall short of God's glory, Jesus said, cut them off. Because it's better for you to take that loss than for your whole body to be thrown into hell. I know in the world sometimes we go through things and we feel like it ain't no hope. We feel like it's all over with. You got people today that's blowing their brains out, jumping. I seen a video on Facebook. And I ain't gonna lie, I'm a crybaby, y'all. I be crying when I see people kill themselves. Because I know where they lift their eyes up at. I seen a video on Facebook of a woman. She jumped off a building and killed herself. She jumped off a building and killed herself. There are people in the world, I know in this world, sometimes you'll be going through so much and you feel like it ain't no more hope. You feel like it's all over with. This the end for me. But I just want to tell you, in this world, there is hope. And it's hope in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who laid his life down for us. But see, in hell, it ain't no hope in hell. See, when you in hell, you can't cry out to Jesus Christ and say, Lord, please forgive me. All you willful sinners out there that keep on sinning willfully and then say, Lord, please forgive me, I repent. You can't do that in hell. Because once you in hell, you in hell. And ain't no coming out. Ain't no grace and mercy in hell. It ain't no joy. It ain't no happiness. It ain't no peace in hell. So for all you people that sinning willfully, the Lord is calling you to come to him and serve him with your whole heart before it's too late. Because when you get to hell, it ain't no more asking for forgiveness. It ain't no more, Lord, I'm sorry, I repent. Lord, give me just this one last chance. I ain't gonna go back and do it no more, oh Lord. I ain't gonna run back to that same woman. I ain't gonna run back to that same man, oh Lord. Just give me one more chance, oh God. You can't do that when you in hell. When you in hell, it's over with. God ain't gonna want to hear nothing else you gotta say. You're gonna be tormented in flames. And like I told y'all, I was just sitting here just staring at my heater and God just started speaking to me. And it's like every day, the Lord just speaking to me more and more and it's starting to scare me, y'all. Because the more God speak to me, it's like the louder he's speaking to me. And the louder he's speaking to me, the more my heart tremble. And God just telling me to warn my people. For I am at the door. Jesus said something else, y'all. In the book of Luke chapter 16. Jesus Christ told us about a story. He told us about this because he wanted us to know that when somebody die in their sins, they lift their eyes up in hell. In the book of Luke chapter 16, when you got time, go read it. Jesus said it was a rich man. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He said it was a rich man. He was full of pride and lifted up. And it was a beggar named Lazarus that came to him every day just wanting the crumbs that fall from his table because he was so hungry. But the rich man looked at him and he let the dogs lick the sores off the beggar body. The rich man wouldn't give him nothing to eat. He was full of himself. Then Jesus told us, he said, it came a time where the rich man and the beggar had died. And the Bible says that the rich man lifted his eyes up in hell. But the beggar, he was comforted in Abraham's bosom. And Jesus started saying things that when I was reading this a while ago, it started scaring me. Jesus said that the rich man, he looked up and seen the beggar in the bosom of Abraham and started saying, "Oh, Abraham, father." For Abraham is the father of many nations. He started crying, "Abraham, father, let Lazarus the beggar, let him dip his finger in water and touch the tip of my tongue, for I am tormented in these flames," he said. But Abraham said to him, "Oh no, when you was on earth, you had your chance to repent. When you was on earth, you had your chance to give your life to Jesus Christ. You had a chance to turn away from your wicked ways. You had a chance to turn away from your pride. But no." He said, "Now you're being tormented. And now Lazarus, he's being comforted. When you was in the world, you received all that you wanted. Jesus Christ wasn't enough for you. You was glad with the life that you was living and seeing. You was comfortable in your sins. And now you're being tormented and the beggar is being comforted," he said. Then the Bible says that the rich man, he looked up to him again and said, Can you at least send him to my father's house? I got five brothers. Send them to my father's house to tell them what hell is like. Tell them they'll listen to him so that they won't come to this place." He said, "Please go warn my brothers of this place." Abraham said to him, he said, "Nah, they got Moses and the prophets." Then the rich man said to Abraham again, he said, "But if somebody come from the dead and tell them, they'll listen to them. They'll listen to somebody who have already died." Abraham said, "No." He said, "If they won't listen to Moses and the prophets, they ain't gonna listen to nobody that came from the dead." As soon as I read that, I began to tremble. And I started thinking about all the prophets and apostles and evangelists and all the saints and servants of God that God is sending out on social media, sending out in the streets, sending the people to warn them of their sins, to warn them of hell, and people ain't taking heed. I often wonder sometimes, y'all. You know, I used to live a life of gangbanging, selling drugs, and I was a sinner. And I lost a lot of friends in the streets. I often wonder if they could come back from hell and tell me what it's like. I often wonder what they would tell me. I wonder what they'll tell me what hell is really like. So I'm making this video because God told me to. And he laid it on my heart to tell you people out there. The hell is real. Jesus said it's a outer darkness. It's a place where it ain't no peace, no joy, no happiness, no hope in hell. When you in hell, you will be tormented. Jesus said the worm never dies. So I imagine it's just bugs crawling in and out of you, tormenting you. And I know what many people saying. You're trying to scare people into heaven. See, this that type of stuff that try to scare people. You trying to beat people on the head with the Bible. Man, if I could knock you out with the Bible, I would. If that's what it's going to take in order for you to obey God, I'd do it. If I could scare you into the kingdom of heaven, I would do it. So I want y'all to know that hell is a real place. But it's also something else that you must know in the book of Revelation chapter 20. Hell is a temporary place that people go to die in their sins. But when all things is finished, John said he saw a vision. He saw death and hell delivered up the dead. He said hell delivered up the dead and they stood before God to be judged and they was thrown in a lake of fire. Hell is a temporary place that people go to die in their sins. Oh, but when the King of Glory returns and that great final judgment appear, the people that's going to come from hell that's being tormented and stand before the Lord again. Revelation 20, go read it. 12 through 15. They're going to stand before the Lord again and be judged. And they're going to go to a greater torment, which is the lake of fire. Then the Bible says in Revelation 20, 15, whoever name is not found written in the Lamb's book of life will be thrown in the lake of fire. Hell is a real place, y'all. Jesus preached more about hell than he did about heaven. Because he'd rather us go to heaven than to hell. He don't want us to die in our sins. The Bible says in 2 Peter, it's not in God's will that anyone should perish, but that all come to repentance. I know a lot of y'all be wanting me to preach this sugar-coated message to make you feel good, to approve of your sins, but I can't do it. I can't do it. Why? Because I love you too much. And I know what God is saying. And he's holding me accountable to everything that I preach. Everything that I preach, I got to stand before God and give account for. And people inbox me all the time. Stop preaching like this. Won't you talk about the love of God? The Bible says in 1 John that the love of God is that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not grievous. That's the problem with the world today. Is we only hearing about the love of God. But what about that God that killed the world full of people with a flood? It only spared 8 people. What about that God? What about that God that sent fire and brimstone from heaven to consume Sodom and Gomorrah because of their sins? What about that God? What about that God that killed 24,000 people because they were having premarital sex? What about that God? What about that God that say, be ye holy for I am holy? What about that God? We don't hear about that God today. We just hear about the God that says he loves you. He loved you so much, he sent Jesus into the world. So now you can live how you want to live. Jesus done died for your sins. That's the type of God we hear about today. But God already proved his love for humanity when he sent Jesus Christ to die on the cross to give his life for us. He already proved his love to the world. Now he expects us to prove our love to him. Why people got itching ears? Why you don't want to hear a message that's going to deliver you, that's going to help you be set free? It takes the truth to be set free. I tell my brothers and sisters that I communicate with all the time, if I'm doing something wrong, rebuke me, offend me, tell me the truth. If that's going to save me from going to hell, then by all means offend me. It's time to really live for Jesus Christ. You don't want to go to hell. You don't want to be thrown into the lake of fire. Your time is running out. And I know what the devil is telling you. Go ahead and click on that pornography website. Go ahead and masturbate. You still just repent when you get done. Go ahead and fire up that blunt. Just repent when you get done. You got time. You know the Lord loves you. Just repent when you done having sex and you ain't married to them. Just repent when you done shacking up and y'all ain't married. Just repent when you get done. You got time. That's what the devil is telling you. Jesus said in John 10:10, the thief, he came only to steal, kill, and destroy. Jesus said he the father of lies. The devil hates you, and he want to kill you. He wants you to go to hell with him, because he know where he going. Revelation 20:10, he going to be cast into the lake of fire for all eternity. So I'm here to tell y'all to send you a warning from the Lord, thy God of Israel. The Lord of hosts, I am that I am is his name. This is his name forever. Don't go to hell behind your sin. Is what you're doing that you know is disobedient to God's word, is it worth going to hell for? That person you keep on having sex with and you ain't married to, is it worth going to hell for? Is it worth you being tormented in flames for all eternity? Is it worth it? The people you keep on treating wrong, the lies you keep telling, is it worth going to hell? Playing church, is it worth going to hell for? Is it worth it? pleasing the lustful desires of your flesh, is it worth going to hell for? Is it worth it? Is it worth being tormented in flames for the rest of your life, for eternity? This is a time that never ends. Eternity. A time that never ends. Have you ever burnt your hand on the stove or touched the oven, trying to pull something out of the oven? You see how fast you reacted? You jerk back, run and put some water on it. You can't do that in hell. No. When you in hell, ain't no water. The water, the river of life, the crystal water, clear as crystal glass, is in heaven. I don't know about you, my friend, but I want heaven. I want to go to heaven. I want to dwell in the very presence of God. Thank you, Father. I want to go to heaven. I don't want to go to a place where I'm going to be tormented for the rest of my life. That's why every day I'm striving to live holy. Every day I'm searching these scriptures. As soon as I get off work, I'm running to the Bible just to make sure that what I did throughout the day line up with God's word. I'm working out my salvation with fear and trembling every day. I'm fasting daily. Sometimes I got to get off social media. Sometimes I got to cut everybody off. I have to text people. Hey, look, don't text my phone for a certain amount of days. Don't call me for a certain amount of days. I'm going to Mount Sinai. I'm going before the face of God. I have to do this. Because guess what? I got to keep my flesh under subjection. So that when I have preached to others, I myself shall be a castaway. How many people preaching and ain't practicing what they preach? Jesus said, we got to practice what we preach. How many of you telling people to repent and come out of their sins, but you ain't repenting and came out of yours? Thou hypocrite. How can you say to your brother, let me take the plank out of your eye, when you got a plank in your own eye? How many of you posting scriptures, but then you ain't even really obeying them? How many of you that got the anointing on your life to preach the message of God, but you still a slave to your sins? The Bible say in the book of James, chapter 3, verse 1. The Bible say, be not many masters, for we shall receive the greater condemnation. Us who preach God's word, we will receive the greater condemnation. If we didn't practice what we preach, God is requiring much more from us. So this is a warning from the Lord thy God of Israel, the creator of the heavens and the earth and everything in it. Jesus Christ, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, the Son of God, the true vine, the bread of life, the Alpha and Omega, which was, is, and is to come. This is a message from the Lord, the Lion of Judah, who was slain as a lamb, faithful and true. Repent and turn from your wicked ways. Well, how do I repent? The way that we repent is by confessing our sins to Jesus Christ. When you confess in your sins, when you come before God and you done got to the place where you want to surrender, where you tired of disobeying God, where you done tried it your way, and now you want to try it God's way, hallelujah. The way that you repent is by confessing your sins to the Lord, acknowledging that you are a sinner. And I know people say, well, just pray the sinner's prayer and you will get to heaven. Ain't no sinner's prayer in the Holy Bible. You don't read it nowhere in the scriptures of no sinner's prayer. But you do read about David said in Psalms 51, verse 10. He was repenting. Create a clean heart in me, O God, and renew the right spirit in me. Blot out my transgressions, that I may teach other people your ways, O Lord. The way that you repent is by acknowledging, knowing that you a sinner. Because the Bible say, if you feel like you ain't never sinned, then you a liar and the truth is not in you. You repent by confessing your sins to Jesus Christ, asking the Lord for forgiveness, coming before him with a willful heart to turn away from your wickedness, and ask the Lord to baptize you with the Holy Ghost. This is what the Bible calls repentance. And the Bible says that if we repent, if we confess and forsake our ways, the Lord will have mercy. The Bible says in 1 John 1:9 that if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Because the Lord loves you. Even while you keep sinning willfully, the Lord still loves you. Even while you keep living in rebellion, practicing witchcraft. For the Bible says in the book of Samuel, rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft. The Lord still loves you. Even though you have backslid and the devil keep telling you it's too late. The devil lying to you. It's not too late. You still breathing. You watching this video. It's still hope for you. God will be done with you when you are in hell being tormented in them flames. God is calling you to repent with your whole heart. The end of all things is near. Hell is real. And she have enlarged herself and opened her mouth wide without measure. I love y'all. God bless you. God is a holy God. Shalom.